kind of grim, don't you think? Well, here's some good news. The bailout plan has been passed. Here's the deal. It went from $700 billion to $800 billion. Now, the reason for that, it costs the taxpayers more. If it costs the taxpayers more, a better chance that the Congress will vote for it. So that's what happened there. And been asking me this today, but did you see the debate last night? And my answer, of course, is, oh, you betcha. But you know, you see them standing there together. You got Palin and you got Biden, and oh my God, they look like the Channel 9 news team, didn't they, a little bit? And before the debate, of course, Sarah Palin goes up to Senator Biden and says, is all right if I call you Joe? And he says, is all right if I call you smoking hot? What? And I don't know if you saw this, but Sarah Palin, the governor's family, was sitting in the front row, and halfway through the debate, her son-in-law made a run for it. Did you see that? During the debate, Palin winked, wrinkled her nose, and they gave a shout-out to a third-grade class. Well, you know, that says commander-in-chief to me right there. All of that. You betcha. I thought she did very well, and then for the talent portion, she was saying, I'm going to wash that man right out of my hair. I don't know what this means, but after the debate, Sarah Palin received a congratulatory call from Bill Clinton. What's that all about? What's going on there? But they say that Sarah Palin, after last night, has locked up the vote of the people who pronounced the word nuclear, so that's good. That'll be good for all of us. And she kept reaching out to Joe Sixpack. She kept invoking Joe Sixpack. And that's because her answers make more sense after six beers. Really, that's how that works. But listen to this. The debate was such a hit that today, in Times Square, all the hookers had their hair in the Sarah Palin beehive. Great.